the biological soil crust, that lightly pigmented guy. Look how strong it is holding that entire piece of soil together. And that's the function that this guy performs in the landscape. It's holding the soil down, resisting wind and water erosion. We like to say that it's keeping the place in place. My name is Sasha Reed and I'm a research ecologist, and we're near Castle Valley, Utah, at the site of a climate manipulation experiment that's been running for almost 15 years. Behind me you can see some of the infrastructure of that climate manipulation experiment. We have infrared lamps that are heating the plants and the soils, and we've altered precipitation patterns in some of the plots to ask questions about how variability in climate affects the community and the functions that the community performs. We started this experiment about 15 years ago because we were really interested in how factors that are a part of climate affect the communities and their function here on the Colorado Plateau. We were interested in how changes in temperature and precipitation might affect plant productivity, the amount of forage that's available for consumption, the biological soil crusts that we have here on the Colorado Plateau that are so important for soil stability and soil fertility. We were really curious about the potential resilience of these communities to changes and climate that were expected at that time. This is an auto chamber that we use to measure the CO2 coming out of the soil through respiration and going into the soil through biocrust photosynthesis. Every hour, this lid will close for a few minutes to let CO2 build up or draw down in the headspace, depending on if respiration is the bigger flux, breathing out CO2 just like us, or if photosynthesis of the biocrust is the bigger flux, bringing carbon dioxide into the system. So it allows us to look at the productivity of the biological soil crust and the health and how these treatments are affecting those patterns. So this experiment has two variables that we use alone and together, and those are increased temperature and altered precipitation. So we warm the biocrusts and the plants and the deeper soils in the plots either 4 degrees Celsius or 2 degrees Celsius above ambient temperature. So the temperatures track the natural temperature. They go up and down, but stay that temperature difference above the ambient temperature around us. And we also alter precipitation patterns by adding big, infrequent pulses of rain during the monsoon or frequent little pulses of rain to see how that change in soil moisture availability interacts with the natural climate and our altered temperature climate to affect the plants and the soils. This is an experiment where we're trying to look at the effects of drought in this system, and so these slats catch rainfall that would otherwise hit the plot and move it off plot so we can look at how drought affects the system. These biocrusts around here almost looked as if they've been burned. That black pigment color that many of the biocrusts have looks charred, but it's not. It's actually pigments that the biocrusts have in order to protect themselves from the intense UV radiation that these desert landscapes have. So there's also green chlorophyll in there, the photosynthetic pigment that plants use too, but that black can overtake that pigment in the way we see it because it's so abundant in order to protect the tissue from UV damage, ultraviolet light damage. Biocrusts use pigment just like our species uses pigment to protect us from UV radiation. If you spend a lot of time in the sun, you get browner because the pigmentation goes up. Biocrusts are using their black pigmentation in the same way. Another thing that we're really interested in is the connection between vascular plants and biological soil crusts and thinking about how they interact to keep soil stable, to affect soil stability, and to keep a lot of productivity in our plants that wildlife and other grazers depend upon. Here in our control plots, you can see the very healthy biological soil crust community in the inner spaces between the plants. Lots of different species, lots of bumpiness. But if you go over here to one of our treatment plots where temperature has been increased to 4 degrees Celsius above ambient, where we've altered the precipitation, you can see the dramatic difference in the biological soil crust community. There is still a biocrust community here, even though it doesn't look like it, but it's just that lightly pigmented cyanobacteria. And that cyanobacteria isn't able to stabilize the soils nearly as well as the community in the control plots, and it isn't able to add the same fertility to the soil. So even just with this change in temperature and change in precipitation, no physical disturbance, we've seen a dramatic effect on the biological soil crust community and on the functions that it performs. Biological soil crusts perform all kinds of important tasks for us here on the Colorado Plateau and in drylands around the world, including soil stabilization and increasing soil fertility. And so we really know that we need these organisms to be able to maintain the function that we expect in terms of forage for plants or not having dust storms blow into our eyes and mouths all of the time. And so we're curious about how biocrusts are going to respond to changes in climate, whether that be interannual variability, year-to-year variability, or whether that be change through time, because that understanding is going to give us options to be able to manage these ecosystems to make sure they continue to provide the services that we really rely upon in this area.